going on, guys? This one is the new MIUI with the ICS build 4.0.4. That would be the version on this. You got the four column lock screen. You have the phone that will unlock to the phone. And next one unlocks to the camera up here. The transitioning, I have it on like really slow motion, so it's kind of cool how I just wanted to try it out. I mean, it comes up pretty slow, so that's why you can set it to however fast you want it to transition. But that is the lock screen right there. See how it transitions? It transitions very slow. From right there on the front screen, or the home screen, we have a couple apps out here already. We have the Gmail. Everything is from the pre-released ICS build. It even comes with the updater, which this is the latest for the HTC Evo 2.4. 13, the MIUI ROM. For those of you that are new and just seeing the MIUI for the first time, this is the most diverse ROM there is in the market. The original creator goes by the name of Taizing. The one that it's on this, I think I forgot his name, but he did his own build on it. But the original creator for MIUI is Taizing, and it's covered like a lot of, this is the only ROM that has the most Android devices on, from Epic Touch to HTC Evo, Thunderbolt, Samsung, Galaxy, so it's very, very flexible. This ROM is pretty neat. Just trying to show some stuff here. Basically, you can move icons into other ones, building a folder right there on your home screen, so you can add more to it, things like that, or you can just bring them back out, just move them back out. The other thing here, it's got that soft feel. On the clock, this is, as you can see, I have the transition on slow, so if you look up on the top, we're in the alarm tab, and then we have the stopwatch, and you can just, you have the timer. The timer, you just slide the clock, and then you just start. When it's done, you can pick any ringtone that'll match with it. The world clock, as you all know, we can add time to it. Honolulu, Hawaii. That's for the clock right there. The music player. This is the first ROM I have ever seen when it first came out that had the music player with the lyrics on it. So if you're playing something, I don't have a song in here that pretty much you can see online. Once you play it on the MIUI player, it has the lyrics coming up on it. So maybe I can try one of these just to see if it's... It's actually downloading, so... I think that's connected to online, so you can try to play something. but I don't have no music on here, so it'll be better if I would have had some music. But anyways, I'll try and put something on there maybe later on in the review, because I have no idea what songs are in here. These are online music, and she's showing 120. Be the music, and let's get back in here. Got some themes up here. It's a lot of themes you can play with. This is one of the ones that's already on there. And if you go online, you have many to choose from. So every menu has an extra page on it. So just make sure you check it thoroughly. Gallery. Not bad. Next one is the camera. That was the still photos. From here you can basically switch over to the camera mode. That one's got a red button. That's the ICS. That you can basically play it back. What I'm trying to look for is the front facing camera and the rear. I don't see the, oh, okay. Switch to camera. Okay, the menu right here is just still photos, panoramic, and video. I don't see the front facing camera. Okay, what's next? Like I said, the icons are pretty much the same ones. Signature merely has the smooth edges. It's pretty good. You've got the email, 4.0.4 build icons, pretty much pretty, you see the Gmail icon right there, the YouTube icon, the updater. As soon as you finish installing, it's going to update you to the latest one. So by the time you finish starting up the phone, it'll automatically update you to the latest software that's there. I don't know if I showed you earlier, this is with the dual signal bar on the top. It has the dual signal bar with the, well, I have the alarm enabled. Maps works fine. I have the navigation works fine. Let's go Pizza Hut. give you some locations right there. And all you gotta do is just...
head north on Conquest Avenue toward East Clinton Street.
And that would be your navigation. With the GPS icon on the top left corner. You have the navigation and the GPS. That's it. YouTube. It's got the ice cream sandwich YouTube app. If you have an account, I mean, you just upload it. This is the ROM right here that we are actually doing a review on right now. Upload button up there, the menu for the settings to find out if you have the most updated version. Let's get into, I don't know if I covered the settings on this, but in the settings menu you have the common settings and then you have the full settings. The common will just show you what some of the switches you can turn on and off, like wallpaper, brightness. Full, you have the full settings right here. And you can scroll all the way down, you'll see everything. According to your account, network, storage, but I want to go see about phone, and that will show you the version and everything on there, with, including the kernel, which is actually the Tiamat kernel, 4.1.0, so actually it's pretty good for the ICS build. Back up a little. Check out the developer options. Like I said, this is where the transition, you can make it go slow and faster. I put it here on the 5. As you can see, the transition tends to be slower. Like a nice fade in and a fade out. Yes. And some people like it fast and some people like it slow. That was in the developer options. And you have the window scale, show rounded corners. This will be for the and you can also show CPU usage on the screen. That's actually the one that's showing up right now. It'll show whatever is using the screen. Show touches is like when you, if you touch the screen, it shows where your finger has touched. For pointer location, it's actually gonna be, if you can see, so that's the full settings. I mean, there is a lot of things in here where you can just basically play with. Let's see. Yeah, some widgets, some big icon widgets you can add on to it. Then you have your regular size icons. Drop down menu screen. have the notification and the toggle switch, which I've seen earlier on some previous Miri ROMs. So, and here you have the screenshot. I guess that just took the screenshot for the home screen. You got your flashlight. And that's about it. Voice dialer. User feedback. You can write something back to the team. Let them know how the ROM feels. So that's about it I can cover right now. I mean, there's a lot more, but sorry guys, that's all the time we have. This is the contact look. And then you have groups. From here, basically toggle to different menus. Go straight to the phone dialing pad and search. And it's using the keyboard too. So keyboard, the ICS board. That's about it. Thank you guys for tuning in. If you guys have any questions, leave me a comment. And please subscribe. This would be the shutdown animation. Alright guys.